Hi everyone, it's Sailor Mimzy. Today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I make envelopes. So this is something new, but I just wanted to share with you guys how I make some envelopes. So here are some examples. There's this one, it's just made out of scrapbook paper. And then different. I feel like such a dork right now, but I love making envelopes. I seriously love making envelopes. For like, you know, writing letters, like sending cards to people. There's some made out of magazines here. Using in my journal or even just the storage. I love making envelopes. And then there's also these little ones here that I'm very happy with. So I use scrapbook paper, recycled books, flyers, magazines, scrap paper. These are made with, you know, when you get like bills or like junk mail or whatever. This is made from those envelopes. My husband made a joke. Well, he tried to make a joke. He was telling me that it was some kind of like envelope inception. It's like making an envelope out of an envelope. Anyways, yeah, I think the best envelopes, one of my favorite ones that turn out, are usually made from like recycled items, just because they have a more unique look to them. Yeah, this size, I guess these sizes are pretty good for using in a journal. If your journal is like an A5 or A6, maybe A6 would be a little too small. Anyways, so I'm just going to move this over and show you guys how I made them. So when I first started doing this whole envelope making thing a few years ago, I used to do just like the basic, just get a scrap piece of paper. So when I was a kid, up until a few years ago, I would make an envelope by just getting a piece of paper, folding it like so, and then taping the sides, put in whatever I have to put in, and then just, you know, tape this part over, and there's the envelope. That still works. But then I think it's funner doing it this way with like different shapes and stuff. So these are what I came up with. Can't really see, these ones are clear. But these are the stencils that I have. So one day I wanted to, I forget what, I wanted to make an envelope for something. I knew that there were stencils that existed, but I needed it right away. So I ended up printing out a stencil of an envelope off the internet onto just computer paper. And then I cut out the computer paper stencil. And I used, these are cutting boards from the dollar store. I had a few of these lying around just because I use them also as cutting mats for like crafting and stuff. I put the paper stencil onto the cutting board, traced it onto the cutting board with permanent marker, and then just cut out of the cutting board. You see the other side has a texture to it. But yeah, so that's how I would make my envelopes, using these homemade stencils. So if you go online, you can see there's like lots of different shapes and sizes. And then I got this, I think, last year or the year before, using a coupon from Michael's. I forget what it's called, but it's made by Martha Stewart. It's this huge, it fits a 12 by 12 sheet of paper, so you know those big squares of scrapbook paper. It fits in here. But on the inside of this, gosh, open. Comes with this kind of bone folder thing, and all these ridges are like where you score the lines. And then inside here, inside the lid, it has the measurements of the envelopes you want to make, or it also makes boxes too, by the way. But yeah, so it has whatever size envelope you want to make, and it tells you what measurement to, you know, make the score at. That's how I make the bigger envelopes that I showed you guys. And they also, it also makes like super small envelopes as well. Oh, I tried to be all creative with this one, so this one opens this way. Yeah, that's how I made these envelopes. You still have to cut with scissors, but it tells you, it makes it a lot easier because it shows you where the notches are for to cut. You can make huge envelopes like that, as well as like teeny tiny ones that could fit like gift cards. So that's super handy. The other envelope making item I have is, so this is the stencil that I used to see, similar to this stencil, before I made like these homemade ones. And this is actually from Rowena's store. She's the owner of Paper Plus Cloth. I know she has this size. I think there's a smaller size and a larger size. I don't remember. But I think this one is supposed to be medium. This one makes these ones, these envelopes. So this is the flap, it folds down. And it's 4¼ by almost 3 inches. So yeah, it's good size for storing little sticker flakes and stamps, and also like using your journal as a pocket. So hopefully I explained how I did this. I will demonstrate with you guys how I use these items. See, whenever we get junk mail, I get excited and look for these envelopes. Because I think the designs on the inside are kind of cool looking. So we'll use one of these. See, I like to incorporate the window in. I'm just lining it up to make sure that you get the window in there. I'm going to just use a pencil to trace around. I need to admit that this stencil, this envelope stencil, is probably my favorite one, because between this and the homemade ones I've made, this one's a lot easier to handle. Because with the flimsy ones that I've made, like, it still works. Obviously you hold it down, you trace around it, but I always find like my pen or pencil or whatever slipping underneath the stencil. And I don't know, it just bugs me. It's not a huge deal, but it bugs me. I'm going to use these beautiful pair of scissors. They're from Ness. She sent these to me because my dangerous scissors were looking a bit too dangerous. I admit, they are pretty dangerous. But these scissors are really awesome. They make a really satisfying, like, it feels really satisfying to cut with them because there's, what did the packaging say? It's like micro, is the word serrated? Serrated blade. Oh gosh, words are escaping me. But it's micro serrated. So when you cut into the paper, it feels good. Oh my gosh, that sounds so weird, doesn't it? But it's really satisfying to use. And my super dangerous scissors that I used to use in my videos are getting put in the junk drawer downstairs. So whoever needs scissors will have to use them. Oh, and these folds here, I trace in there because it shows you where to fold. That's pretty handy. So here we have our envelope. This reminds me of, sorry, this is the shape of it. It just made me think of a feminine product. So yeah, we fold where the lines are. Sometimes it's a little tricky because you know how the envelope is the recycled envelope that I'm using and it's pre-folded, so sometimes it's tricky to get past that pre-folded line, but it's possible. Oh, and the other thing we're going to need is a glue stick, or also you can use washi tape, of course, or both. Just going to fold it like that. Ooh, I'm going to trim it just a little bit off. See, I overfolded it. So we'll just trim it off just a little bit, as if it never happened. So I grab some scrap paper here to use as a surface because I didn't want to get this all gunky. I just have my regular glue stick. Okay, so Wait, I put glue on this. So I like to have it so that the longer flap is down and then the shorter flap is over it. So I put glue on the longer flap. I bought a package of these glue sticks and they're a lot tinier than the ones that I usually use. And also for some reason they're really difficult to open. So whenever I'm done using this, I just put the lid on it. I never snap it shut because otherwise I'll have troubles opening it. Even my husband had problems opening it. It's ridiculous. It does say extra strength on it. Maybe that's what they meant. Okay, and we also put a little bit of glue on the shorter flap. I don't put glue on the entire flap, just maybe 3/4 or half, just because I don't want to get glue on the inside of the envelope, if that makes sense. And then I just fold it over. And voila! We have an envelope. Let's put something inside just to see what it looks like. This was sitting on my desk. Maybe it'll fit. Ooh, it fits. Okay. So there you have an envelope. And then we can just fold this. It's closed. That's pretty cute. So there's that. And then we have some of this really cool paper left over, so I'll probably use it in my journal or something as like a background or who knows what. It's from recycling, but the only bad thing is you have to like keep track of all this stuff and you end up with piles and piles of scraps. And you have to remember to use it, otherwise it's all in vain. Okay, so then I have this paper, kind of similar to the first one. If you could make another envelope out of this, it's kind of small, but if I could, then I would have. And this one, oh look, it just fits. Sometimes, even if the paper is a little too short, I still do it anyways. Because it's not a huge deal. Do I want to use this one? Okay, I will use this one. So yeah, you can't really tell because it's a clear stencil, but part of it hangs over the other side. It's not a huge difference. And also, obviously, if you're going to be reusing an envelope like this, make sure your personal information isn't on the opposite side. Because it could happen, you might forget and then use it for something to give to somebody or whatever. You might not want that information out there. I love cutting with these scissors. Oh my gosh. Okay, so here we have the envelope cut out. So this flap over here looks a little bit bigger than that one, so I'm going to assume that this is the top. So I'm just going to fold this over. Maybe they're the same size. They do look like the same size. One of my stencils that I made, I traced and or cut out wrong, so it's kind of off, but I still use it. Yeah, this one. It looks totally off, but it's still like, I still used it. Oh my gosh. Alright, so yeah, both of these actually kind of look like about the same size to me, so I'm just gonna choose whatever side at the bottom to glue down. So I'm gonna fold it first before I put glue on. It makes it a little easier. Alright. So just a little bit of glue here. Oh, there's this envelope. All done. a little bit bigger than this guy. The first one that we made. Alright, and we have one more of these guys left. So I will go with, will this fit? This is a really fun shape. Let's see if I have an envelope here so I can show you guys what it looks like when it's done. Oh yeah, also from that Martha Stewart, like the scoring and envelope and box making thing, you can also make square envelopes. Oh, that was pretty cool. So this is just using scrapbook paper that I had, like excess scrapbook paper. Or extra scrapbook paper. Okay, yeah, so from this really neat stencil, you get this envelope. So this is made from a book that was falling apart, like a recycled book. It's kind of cool. I really like how it's like round. It's a pretty good size too. Let's size comparison it. Line it up so that I don't screw up the plastic window. Have I mentioned I love these windows? Okay, let's get folding. So this might be tricky because there's that pre-folded line right there. So just gotta line it up with where the flaps start. It's not going to turn out perfect, but it's good enough. This one's a lot different from the other envelopes, because as you can see, there's one huge flap there and then this tiny little tab here. So we put glue on this and then fold it over. But make sure not to put glue on the whole thing, otherwise you'll be losing some envelope space on the inside, because the glue will stick to the inside part of the envelope. And then I'm just going to fold the bottom flap again before I put glue on. I think I'm going to add washi to this actually, because when I fold it, it has that, oh you guys can't even see it, the plastic, the edge of the plastic is like exposed right there, and I want to keep it secured, so I'm actually going to use a bit of the old washi, so we'll go with this pattern. I'm just going to put a bit of glue on anyways, so we're just going to stick some here. Then we're just gonna fold it over to the other side. Oh my gosh, I'm kind of tempted to just line the whole thing with it, like on all the edges. I love these envelopes. Okay, well, that turned out pretty good. Oh wait, we have to demonstrate its functionality here. We can. Ooh, I have an idea. So we'll put this back into that first envelope and then we'll take it a step further. Woohoo! It turned out really awesome though, I liked it. Surprise! I guess it's not really a surprise because there's a freaking window. But here are the envelopes that we made today using made with this DIY stencil. And this one at the end was made with this. This one. And this cute one here was made with this awesome one. Oh, I guess I could demonstrate to you guys how to use that Big Martha Stewart thing. But there are videos online. I did have to watch a couple of YouTube videos just to get the hang of using this, I forget what it's called. It's like a Martha Stewart envelope and box making scoreboard. I really don't know what it's called. But yeah, I did have to use some YouTube videos to get the hang of using that. So I'll let you guys look that up if you're interested. It's really easy though, and it's honestly fun. And I know I sound like a sad person, but they're so fun to make. Like, they're, it's addicting to make envelopes. Well, for me anyways. Yeah, so hopefully you guys understood my explanation of how I made these stencils. And also, make sure you check out Rowena's store, Paper Plus Cloth, on Etsy. So much cute stuff. I really want to get the other sizes of this stencil. They're super handy. So yeah, I think that's all I wanted to show you guys today. Like I said, I did have a different video planned, but the supplies that I needed to do it are kind of all over the house. I have yet to gather them, but for this quick envelope making tutorial, everything was like pretty much right in my room here. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, comments, or anything like that, just leave it in the comment section below. Talk to you guys later. Bye!